Hello everyone, welcome again to MW Newscast. My name is Michael, and today we have interesting very fast stories of events happening around the world. Let's start with first story. Honey could be used to make brain-like computer chips. During the past months, you may have heard about a shortage of semiconductors or chips that have affected many industries. Producing automobiles, graphic cards, video game consoles, computers and other products that require them. This crisis won't be over soon. Well, honey, one of our lovely foods could become the sweet solution to the global shortage of semiconductors. Scientists from the Washington State University in the US suggest that honey could be used to produce environmentally friendly computer chips that can process and store data, similar to the human brain. The researchers have proved that honey can be used to make memory store, a component similar to our transistor that can process and store data in memory. This is a small device with a simple structure, but a similar functionality to a human neuron. They found that a biodegradable honey memory store was able to emulate human synapse and had the ability to switch on and off very quickly. And since honey does not spoil, it means computer chips can remain stable and reliable for a very long time. We hope this new technology will be made available very soon worldwide and to potentially solve the global shortage of chips. The next story, plastic pollution is a never-ending problem. Microplastics found in human lung tissues. Few weeks ago, researchers in the Netherlands found microplastics in the bloodstream of live human patients. Now, a team of researchers from the University of Hull and Castle Hill Hospital, both in the UK, are found for the first time. Minute particles of plastic in lung tissues removed from live human patients. Out of 13 samples, they found the particles in 11 of them. The most surprising thing is that these plastic particles were found in the lower regions of the lung, where airways are supposed to be much smaller, which prevents small particles to reach these areas. Given that plastics have been around for a long time, it is obvious that microplastics are ubiquitous. If they are getting into our bodies during inhalation and consumption of food and drinks. So far, scientists have not identified direct harmful impact to our bodies, but they will continue studying. These particles may pose greater risks to some people than to others. The only thing for sure is that there is no microplastic-free place in our planet, not even in our bodies. Last news, birds are more colorful closer to the equator. Almost 3 centuries ago, naturalists postulated that birds that live closer to the equator are more colorful. Now, scientists have confirmed this theory using artificial intelligence technology. Biologists from the University of Sheffield in England studied more than 4,500 species of passerine birds or songbirds, such as wrens, sparrows, and blackbirds, using photographs, pixels from plumage, and deep learning, a kind of artificial intelligence technology. The biologists ranked the birds by colorfulness compared to where they came from, and found that birds are brighter, closer to the equator, and duller the farther they are from it. There may be many reasons for this to happen. Among them, the luxury vegetation in the tropics that act as natural camouflage for the birds all year round, while those closer to the poles have to adapt to bare trees during the winters. Also, diet can play a key role, as birds in the tropics eat fruits and floral nectar. Now, if you want to see more colorful birds, you know where to go. Definitely interesting stories. And that's all for this edition. Subscribe and share with your friends and contacts. Thanks for watching MW Newscast. Again, this is Michael and see you in the next edition.